Welcome to Esoteric Detective, my name is Emma. We take photos every day. But out of the hundreds of millions taken around the world, there are a few photos that are just haunting. And after combing the internet, I bring you six of the most haunting photographs you will ever see. But before we begin, just a warning that some of the photographs will make you feel uneasy since they depict people in sometimes harrowing situations. They are not for the faint-hearted. Also, these are real people, and I would just like to add before we go on, that my heart truly goes out to those involved. It truly does. So stay tuned as Esoteric Detective brings you, 6 haunting last moments captured on camera. Number 6. If you look closely, you can see two people hugging at the top of a burning windmill. This happened when a crew of maintenance workers at the top of a 67-meter, or 215-foot, windmill in the Netherlands, caught on fire. They were in a gondola next to the turbine when the fire broke out and blocked their only escape. They held each other in their last moments as firefighters were helpless to try and save them. One of the workers jumped to their death, while the other stayed and died in the blaze. The fire was believed to be the result of a short circuit, which created a spark and ignited the large amounts of flammable lubricants within the windmill. Number 5. In this photo we see Tyler Hadley with a party-goer at Tyler's own party he threw at his parents' home. But little did those at the party know, at the time, while they partied with Tyler, was that only hours ago, before the party, Tyler had murdered both his parents in their bedroom with a hammer. There was even a chilling text that he sent on Facebook, before the party, in reply to one poster asking if the party was still on, to which he replied, "Don't worry, parents won't be here." In the photo we see the strange disturbed look in his eyes, and we can only speculate as to what he was thinking, knowing that his parents' bloody bodies were so nearby. Number 4. The Regina K. Walters photo. It was taken by serial killer Robert Ben Rhodes, of his victim, 14-year-old runaway Regina K. Walters, moments before her death. Serial killer Robert Ben Rhodes would drove an 18-wheeler around the United States with a torture chamber in the back of his truck. This photo was taken in an abandoned Illinois barn, where Rhodes killed Walters after cutting off her hair and making her wear a black dress and heels. You can see the true distress on Regina's face, and it is heartbreaking to look at. One can only wonder why he wanted Regina to wear such clothing. Was he trying to dress her up as someone from his past? It is unknown, and probably will always remain a mystery. Number 3. In the photograph you can see a celebration. Family members and friends all around. But if you look closely in the background you can see a man holding a gun. The person that is taking the photograph is Reynaldo Dagsa, a Filipino politician, who on New Year's, January 1, 2011, caught his own assassination on camera a split second before he was shot in the head and killed. It is speculated that the light on the gun, that can be seen, is the actual muzzle flash. Number 2. In this photograph we see the last moments of a 2-year-old toddler, James Bulger, as he was being led away by one of his murderers. James Bulger was taken to a location, where he was tortured and murdered by 2 10-year-old boys, Robert Thompson and John Venables. His poor body was found beside a railway line, in Liverpool, 2 days after his murder. Thompson and Venables were charged with murder in 1993. Making them the youngest convicted murderers in modern English history. Number 1. On June 15, 1989, a Polaroid photo was found in the parking lot of a convenience store in Port St. Joe, Florida, of a young woman and a boy, both gagged and seemingly bound. The boy's identity is unknown, but the identity of the young woman was confirmed by her mother, as Dara Callio, by the scar on her leg. In addition, a paperback copy of V.C. Andrews' My Sweet Audrina can be seen lying next to the young woman, her mother stating that My Sweet Audrina was one of Tara's favorite books. Scotland Yard also analyzed the photo and concluded that the woman was Dara Callio. And with that, we come to an end. If you liked my list, please like and subscribe. And as always, this is Emma, from Esoteric Detective, and thanks for watching. And do stay tuned for more. Goodbye.